Hello guys, and today I'm going to show the comparison between the Acer Nitro 5 and the ASUS ROG Strix Hero Edition. So before we start the video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. And with that being said, let's get started. The Acer Nitro 5 and the ASUS ROG Strix are two gaming laptops that come in at around $800. For that price, both laptops offer some really great value with nice specs, but in this video, we'll compare these laptops and see which one is the better pick for you. We'll be comparing these laptops in these categories, including design and build quality, displays, performance, and battery life. These are the most basic and most important requirements for a laptop, and that is why we'll be comparing the laptops in these. And with that out of the way, let's get right into the first aspect, which is the design and build quality on both laptops. The design and builds on both laptops is good, but it is quite clear that one has a lot more style as compared to the other. The Acer Nitro 5 has a fully plastic build with a texture finish and red accents that look neat, and it has a very obvious gamery look to it. It looks quite good in person, but if you compare it to the ROG Strix, it looks a bit bland. The ASUS ROG Strix Hero Edition also has a plastic build. When you look at the back, you get a really unique and impressive look with a two-tone texture finish that makes this laptop stand out from the rest. From the front, the laptop looks normal like any other laptop, but when you look at the back, it is completely different from anything. Both laptops are also average in terms of size for gaming laptops, but the ASUS is a bit thinner and lighter. Therefore, I feel like the ASUS ROG Strix Hero Edition is easily the better laptop in terms of build quality and looks. The next component we'll be taking a look at are the displays. The displays just on paper have some serious differences in favor of the ASUS ROG Strix when compared to the Acer Nitro 5. The ASUS ROG Strix Hero Edition has a 15.6-inch Full HD IPS panel with a 120Hz refresh rate and a response time of 3 milliseconds. This is undoubtedly really impressive at this price point, and you don't see this feature even on higher-end laptops most of the times. The panel itself is really good looking with accurate colors and contrast, good viewing angles and good brightness, but other than that, the 120Hz refresh rate adds a lot of smoothness to everything including gaming, and the fast response rate is great and useful for any game requiring quick reflexes. The Acer display on the other hand is basic and doesn't have the extra features, but it is still pretty good for the price. Here also, you get a 15.6-inch Full HD IPS display that looks nice with all the important aspects, but this time it is just a 60Hz panel like most laptops. Even though it's not bad at all, the ASUS definitely has the better features, and that is why it takes this round as well. Now, we'll take a look at the most important aspect for a gaming laptop, which is the performance. The specs on both laptops are pretty much the same with some changes in storage. The specs on both therefore include the Intel Core i5-8300H processor, 8GB of RAM, a 1TB hard drive and a 128GB SSD on the ASUS, and just a 256GB SSD on the Acer, and the NVIDIA GTX 1050 Ti GPU. Overall, both laptops have similar performance due to the same specs, and the performance from these specs is really good. We are able to do gaming at 1080p really easily, with most games running at high settings with more than playable FPS. The only difference you'll see here is in the storage, but you can change the storage configuration options on both when buying, and both have good storage speeds. Overall, this one is a tie due to the same specs on both. Last but not least, we have the battery life category. The Acer Nitro 5 in this category fares a lot better, and here you can expect some above average battery life for a gaming laptop. You can make the laptop last up to 5 hours on a single charge, which doesn't sound impressive, but when compared to the ASUS, it does much better. The ASUS ROG Strix has some poor battery life that can last you not more than 4 hours on a charge, and while gaming, it can last only a mere 15 minutes before giving up. Overall, this round goes to the Acer Nitro 5 for its better run times. So the final verdict for the comparison is that even though both laptops do really well in most categories, with the ASUS being better in some and the Acer being better in some. If you're looking for something that will perform great and will have above average battery life, then you should consider the Acer Nitro 5, but as a gaming laptop, and if I were to buy one of these, I would put my money on the ASUS ROG Strix for its much better display, giving a better experience in gaming. So that's it for the video guys, thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to the channel, and I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.